Hello people, in this video we want to look at varicose veins. So this is the topic in surgery for you. So it's a very important topic even in your clinical presentation. So basically in your long cases, right, you have varicose veins, very important. So basically how varicose veins happen, because the veins have to drain against gravity, isn't it? The veins are supposed to drain against gravity, vertically they're supposed to drain, right? So what can happen, these veins can have pooling of blood. The valves can be absent or incompetent or weak, and hence there can be pooling of blood here. So there is dilated, tortuous, elongated superficial veins of the limb are called varicose veins. So first let's get with the definition. We have written that here. Dilated, elongated, tortuous, superficial veins of the limbs are called varicose veins. So have you got the definition, guys? So that is the definition. Okay. So now let's move on to who has it. Actually, it says that it is more common in women, but all the patients that I saw were men, isn't it? Especially people who stand for a long time. So like a policeman, security, watchman, right? Patrol bunk workers, they are saying. Teachers, surgeons, can they be? Whoever stands for very long time, okay? So then let's move on. See, in this they are telling you a 45-year-old male who's a waiter in a hotel. So obviously you can understand that, right? And he has the swelling in the inner aspect of the right leg for 3 years. So you can understand, he said there are swellings of the vein in the inner aspect of the right leg for 3 years. That is how it started, right? The swelling reduces when he lies down. Okay, so you have to always examine the patient in the standing position. When he lies down, the swellings may of the veins may reduce. Okay, then pain has started in the right calf region for last 2 years. Okay. And when does he have pain? Towards the evening. Okay? Because he has pain. He stands the whole day and in the evening he has pain. Now he is telling that he has one more problem. That is dark pigmentation of the skin around the ankle for last 1 year. So first of all, what started? The swelling of the vein. Okay? Then he is telling pain, and then he is telling about pigmentation. Dark pigmentation since 1 year. Okay? Great. So now let's see what are the chief complaints people will come with. Asymptomatic, or they can have appearance of varicosity, that is swelling of veins, right? This is what we said. Then pain they can have, and what type of pain? If it's bursting pain, it can be while walking, if they have bursting pain, it can be deep vein thrombosis, which is a complication. There can be, let's go with pigmentation, eczema, which will cause itching, right? And there can be even ulcers, okay? So these are the symptoms that they may present with. So look at the photos here, guys. They are showing eczema here, dermatitis, and observe the pigmentation, lipodermosclerosis and ulcer formation. So basically here it has gone to the sclerosis and also ulcer formation. Anyways, they can be presenting factors. Look at this, varicose veins. Now there's a venous ulcer here. Okay. Then look at this, a case of lipodermosclerosis. Anyways, symptoms, you won't write all these terms. Just telling you. Then look at this photo here, where exactly the ulcers will be there. Gaiter areas, okay, are those areas where the skin changes and venous stasis ulcer occur due to ambulatory venous hypertension and incompetent perforators. So this is where usually you will see the ulcers, okay, because of this venous stasis of the blood. How's it going, people? Varicose veins is very important and long topic. I hope you will be able to survive this. Okay, shall we continue, people? Okay, so very important focus here, guys, that varicosity doesn't have to be only this lower limbs. It can be even esophageal varices, etc. But here we are focusing on what? On the lower limb. Okay, so basically here it can be the long saphenous or the short saphenous. You can see long saphenous or the great saphenous, you can see it is medial, right? So the origin is medial part of the dorsal venous arch, and the location is in the front of the medial malleolus. Okay. And what about the short saphenous? It's the lateral part of the dorsal venous arch. It is behind the lateral malleolus. Okay. This long one has around 15 to 20 valves, and the short one has only one valve. Both of these will end in the saphenofemoral junction. SFJ, SFJ. Whatever they say, SFJ, no, it's nothing but saphenofemoral junction, guys. So you should know. Both of these terminate in the saphenofemoral junction. So do you know where the saphenofemoral junction is? You will have to know this in, you'll need it in palpation. Now, why does a varicose vein happen, guys? So we will look at, so primary means you don't know the cause. Either these valves are absent, or even if these, they are present, they are very weak, kind of a thing. Secondary means some cause is there, like pregnancy is there, some pelvic cancer is there, like there's some fibrosis, prolonged immobilization. So this is what has happened in our patient, right? Prolonged immobilization, right? If they're taking oral contraceptive pills also, it is they're talking about. So all this you'll have to ask in the you'll have to ask all this in the what? In the histo-HOPA, okay? So this Klippel-Trenaunay syndrome is valveless syndrome, okay? Just remember, that's why you will have to ask family history of similar condition also. Now we'll move on to past history, guys. Then personal history, basically his sleep will be disturbed if he has pain, right? He'll have to elevate his leg and sleep, etc. Itching he can have because of the venous stasis causing eczema, itching, right? Hemosiderin deposit can cause hyperpigmentation, etc. Then what about history of alcohol and smoking? Actually, here smoking can lead to DVT, but alcoholism as such, they are not directly linking with varicose veins. Coming to family history, you will ask about similar history in the family because valves can be absent or weak as a familial condition. And then you will ask about standard other conditions. Now we have to move to general physical examination for this patient. Guys, happy that we have reached somewhere now? Yes. So, general physical examination, patient is moderately built, moderately nourished, basically based on his height and weight, you're going to decide this, right? Moderately built. Built is something that is because of height, right? Moderately nourished. Nourishment indicates something that is acute thing. Built is something which is chronic. He has grown tall for years, right? That's the thing. Then you will get the BMI. If they are obese, then they can have more problem with varicose veins. So, obesity can put extra pressure, right? Pressure on these valves of the veins, okay? Then what are we looking at, people? We are looking at general examination. So, we are looking now at Pickle, okay? So, we are done with this well-built, well-nourished, conscious, cooperative, well-oriented to time, place, person, height, weight, BMI, okay? Then, Pickle, we are saying about pallor, icterus, cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy, generalized edema. You can check for all this. Then let's move on, guys. Vitals, you will check for blood pressure, respiratory rate, pulse, temperature, and oxygen saturation. Okay, is it going fine? Now we have to go to, do you want to do a head-to-toe examination? This is something you have to decide. Usually this they will do in, what I understand is, in a case of jaundice or something, they will do head-to-toe examination. One more condition I remember they doing head-to-toe examination. Anyways, do a head-to-toe, just generally check, okay? Then let us go to local examination of the varicose veins. You have to take the patient's consent. Expose the patient from where to where will you expose, guys? Basically, umbilicus to feet, shall we say? Then examine the patient in standing position, very, very important. This is extremely important to remember that in hernia and varicose veins, you will examine the patient in standing position. Okay? So now let us start off with inspection. What do you say, people? Let's start off with inspection, okay? So basically, what will you see? You will see only around 1, 2, 3, 4 things you're seeing. Varicose veins, you will see varicose veins, dilated, elongated, tortuous veins, you will see. Right, you will know if it is medial side, it will be great saphenous system. If it is lateral, it will be short saphenous system. Can it be both, guys? What do you say? Then you will see swelling of the leg. Is it a localized swelling? Okay, which will be a superficial system is affected. Generalized, maybe deep vein thrombosis. If there is generalized swelling of the leg, remember, if there is generalized swelling of the leg, it will be because of deep vein thrombosis. So you can write only local swellings. If you want to write generalized swelling, it will mean that the person has deep vein thrombosis, which is a complication, remember, okay? Then changes in the leg skin, you look for color. It can be red or what? Do you want to say that? That means it means superficial thrombophlebitis. Texture of the skin, how will you say? Is it stretched? Okay, then you will talk about eczema, pigmentation, ulceration, scars. Scars, remember, they may have had prior surgery for the same condition. Okay, are you focusing, guys? So what are we looking at? Local examination, you are looking at inspection. Loss of hair, you will see it could be, what is this? Loss of hair won't be there, guys, because loss of hair is more like a PVD, peripheral vascular disease thing. They can go into gangrene, especially the tips, right? Anyways, this won't be there, I'm thinking. Then, brittleness of nail you can check. Then cough. Guys, focus here. This is not just cough. Doesn't happen just only in hernia. Cough impulse, you will check even in varicose veins. So you will ask the patient to cough and you will note whether there is any impulse. Is there any impulse on coughing at the saphenous opening? Okay, this will be saphenovarix. This test is also known as Morrissey test. Okay, Morrissey test. Okay, you can do that. You can check that inspection, palpation, everything you can do. Coming to this white leg and cyanotic mottled skin. So look at this. Phlegmasia alba dolens and phlegmasia cerulea dolens. Look at this. Some massive edema. Okay. Here massive tight edema. So basically what will happen in these people? The ankle pulse may not be palpable. Venous gangrene may happen in these people because there is tight edema. Occlusion of not only the major draining veins but also the collateral veins. Everything is occluded in that. Cyanotic it will become. I see inspection. Now you focus on one thing. In case there is an ulcer, for ulcer you will have to do everything. Inspection, again palpation and the all that you will have to do. Okay. So again inspection for ulcer you will write everything. Site, size, margin, edge, floor, surrounding pigmentation, all that you will write. Right. Okay. Then you will see if there is any deformity. Okay. Deformity also you will see if it is there. The deformity that can be there in these people is talipes equinovarus. Varus. Okay. So you will have to learn these terminologies. What is this varus, equinus and all that. Okay. Then. Now let's go to palpation, guys. So we have come to a level now. Let's move on to palpation. So warming your hands. Let's get started. Local rise of temperature you will check. Tenderness you will check. You will confirm all the inspectory findings, whatever you saw. What were the inspectory findings, by the way, did you forget? You will check for swelling, skin change, cough, impulse, that is Morrissey's test. So you will check if there is any impulse happening at the saphenous opening, right? Then, let's get back here. Palpation, yeah, here we are. Then you will check for pitting edema. So, patient will usually have pitting edema. The one that we checked today had pitting edema. Thickening of skin, remember there can be thickening of skin and there is a terminology for this lipodermosclerosis if it has progressed, okay, progressive sclerosis and of the skin and the subcutaneous tissue will occur. Why? Because of this fibrin deposit, okay, there can be tissue death, scarring, okay, due to chronic venous hypertension. There can be ulcer, we told you what and all you have to do, alright. Now, palpation means, you know, there are so many tests, guys, so you have to know at least 8 tests are there here that you should know. Let's look at the names here. All these tests you'll have to do and tell whether it's positive, negative, what you found. Okay? Then we'll come to a conclusion later. Brody-Trendelenburg test. See, there's a Trendelenburg operation, Trendelenburg gate, so many things are there on earth, right? This is Brody-Trendelenburg test in which you have type 1, type 2. Then you have 3 tourniquet tests or multiple tourniquet tests which you will have to look at. Then which is the next one here? Perthes test. Then you have a modified Perthes test, Pratt's test, Fagan's test, Schwartz test, Morrissey's cough impulse. This you have already seen. Okay. Can you tell all those names? Very hard, isn't it? Okay. Anyways, look at this test in varicose vein examination. You can check for saphenofemoral incompetence, perforator incompetence or deep vein thrombosis you can check. Okay, so look at the tests here. Trendelenburg test, Morrissey cough impulse. We'll talk about saphenofemoral incompetence. Then you have perforator. See, we'll tell you what these perforators are. Just hold on. Okay, then you have Trendelenburg 2 in that. We told you, not type 1, type 2. Type 1 is talking about saphenofemoral incompetence. Type 2 will talk about perforator incompetence. Then tourniquet test, that multiple tourniquet test, etc. We told you. Pratt's test, Fagan's test, everything. We'll talk about perforator. Deep vein thrombosis, you have Perthes, modified Perthes, Homan's, Mosses. I think these two, they don't do anymore. Homan and Mosses, so you don't have to bother. The same thing that you saw written in different format. SF incompetence, cough impulse test and Trendelenburg 1. Perforator incompetence is, how will you check? Perforator incompetence, Trendelenburg 2, multiple tourniquet test, Fagan's test and Pratt's test or something was there, right? And then the superficial column of blood is Schwartz test anyways. Modified Perthes, etc. We'll talk about deep vein thrombosis, okay? How will you find the saphenofemoral junction? Now, before we go into all these tests, you should know some anatomy, right? Otherwise, how will you understand? Correct? So, first, see how to find the saphenofemoral junction. So, saphenofemoral junction is what? It's the termination of the great saphenous vein into the femoral vein. It lies at the saphenous opening. Where do you find the saphenous opening? So, it is 3.5 centimeter below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. So easy, 3.5 centimeter below, 3.5 centimeter lateral. Okay, this will give you the saphenofemoral junction. Okay, see, basically when you're talking about the anatomy of the venous system of the leg, focus guys, you have the superficial system, which is nothing but the long and the short saphenous veins, and then you have their tributaries, which will all be the superficial. So saphenous and all is superficial. Then you have the perforators and you have the deep. What do these perforators do? See, this will connect the superficial and the deep system. That's it. Okay. Now, what is this deep? Deep basically has, this is high pressure. Okay. Superficial system will be low pressure. That you can remember. And what else? In deep system, what and all are there? Femoral, popliteal, vein, anterior tibial, posterior tibial, peroneal. Okay. So, basically, how these drain? Because of calf muscles, there's a calf muscle pump, right? So, basically, there's these calf muscles will contract and relax and the blood will return to the heart. Okay. So that you should know. Another thing is the valves. Okay. The valves, where and all are they present and where and all are they absent? You should know this. Some physiology also, if you know, it is good. So how do you ensure, guys, that this blood doesn't return once you have pumped it? Right. Why does the blood should not return? So for that you have valves, right? The long saphenous, we already told you, it has some 14 valves. Short saphenous has only one valve. The inferior vena cava, common iliac and all, they don't have valves. Okay. So they should know this. So what happens if you are sleeping then? Oh, then who's going to do all that? There's some vis ergo of the circulation. That is the pressure transmitted from the arterial tree. Pressure from the arterial tree passes the capillary bed to the venous side. Okay. Then one more thing is there called as negative intrathoracic pressure. So that will obviously help the draining. Then you have venae comitantes. What is venae comitantes? Let's understand. So this is nothing but vein accompanying the artery. If you can understand the reason, then it's fine. Okay. Now you have understood all this. Now let us move on to the perforators. We had to look at the perforators. Guys, this is very important part. You need to understand this. Okay. So the perforators, the mnemonic is hunting dog bites three cocks. Is it becoming too much, guys? Just focus here. Very easy. Hunting dog is there. It bites three cocks. Okay. This is the mnemonic for the perforators. So you know that there is thigh perforator, knee perforator and leg perforator, right? Look at this. So look at this photo. You will be able to understand. So you here you have the SFJ. Then you have the Hunterian perforator, Dodd perforator, Boyd perforator and Cockett. There are three looks like. Okay. 1, 2, 3. So hunting dog bites three cocks. Okay. Three Cockett you can remember. So look at this guys. Look at this. Posterior inferior to medial malleolus. Guys, touch the medial malleolus. Okay. You know that they are the great saphenous, right? Medial malleolus. So posterior inferior to medial malleolus, then 10 centimeter above the medial malleolus, then 15 centimeter above the medial malleolus. You're going up and up. Those are the three Cockett. Then you have the Boyd and then above that you have the Dodd. Where what will be there above it? Hunterian. Hunterian, Dodd, Boyd, Coyd. Hunting dog bites three cocks, right? Then they are talking about some perforators which they are not constant. Okay. Another diagram showing some anatomy. We'll skip this. So now we have to look at independent tests, guys. Let us look at this in next video. But anyways, just see what lies ahead. You have Brody, Trendel and Berg test. In that you have type 1 and type 2. Right, and then you have multiple tourniquet test. Okay, so this you will be able to locate the perforator also which is having problem. Then Perthes test, basically this is to check DVT, isn't it? And always there is, you are checking for pain here. What will you look for? Cramps. Then, modified Perthes. Pratt's test. You can see this blowout. What do you mean by blowout, guys? A localized dilatation of the vein which is dome-like or ballooned out. Fagan's test. You will palpate the defect in the deep fascia at these spots. You will palpate what? The defect in the deep fascia. Schwartz test, basically here you are checking for the column of blood which is superficial, right? So you just directly make them stand, put the thumb there and from here if you tap, you can feel the pulse on top, right? That's it. Impulse is felt in the thumb at the saphenous opening. So this will imply that the valves are incompetent, they are saying, okay? This will indicate the valves are incompetent because you are able to feel the pulse. Morrissey's cough impulse, we told you. Right? So it will indicate cephalofemoral incompetence. These are tests to know the DVT. Homan's sign, Morrissey's sign, but looks like these tests are not done these days. Because you're checking for DVT and it can dislodge the thrombus. Percussion is same as Schwartz test. You're feeling the impulse. Morrissey's cough impulse is also there saying auscultation is that itself. Okay. What else you have to check in these people? You have to check the regional lymph nodes. You have to check the other limb. Do not forget. Then you will measure the circumference of limbs. Okay. And you will say if there's any swelling. Arterial pulsations you can feel. What in all arteries you will check? Dorsalis pedis artery, posterior tibial, right? What else can you check for? Popliteal, all those pulses you can check for. Then abdominal examination you will do, right? We're just going a little fast from here, guys. Just look at this. Systemic examination, cardiovascular system, S1, S2 heard, no murmurs, you can say. Respiratory sound, normal vesicular breath sounds, bilateral. Abdomen, palpable mass if you feel, guys, this is where you have to pay attention. Is it a pregnancy? Is there a fibroid? Because a pelvic tumor, etc. can cause, right? Ovarian cyst, carcinoma, cervix or rectum. So this is something you have to wake up and observe. No focal neurological deficit. If you want, you can write. Okay, then this is the summary they are telling you after all the examination. Remember that waiter who had come to us as a case? Look at this. On examination, okay, varicosity affecting the great saphenous system of the right lower limb, they saw, okay, and they're talking about some communicating and etc., all those things you can say, some tributaries, etc., dilated, etc., that's also they're saying. Dark pigmentation is marked around the ankle, they're saying, in the right leg. Trendelenburg, what happened to that test? It's positive. It is suggesting saphenofemoral junction incompetence. That means type 1 is positive of Trendelenburg test, right? Then some perforators are also incompetent at the lower level. Multiple tourniquet test you will do and you will see at what level there is incompetence of these perforators. So they are saying it is incompetent at the adductor canal, below knee, at 15 cm and 5 cm medial ankle perforator. So they are talking about ankle perforators here also. Okay. Schwartz test is positive. That means they felt the impulse. That means valves are not okay. Isn't it? Fagan's test is positive. So what did they see that? They are feeling the gap in the deep fascia at 15 cm and 5 cm above the medial malleolus. Perthes test is negative, suggesting that there is no deep vein thrombosis. I think there should have been a word thrombosis. Oh, deep veins are patent. Okay. Arterial pulses in the lower limbs are normal. So arterial pulses are normal. No issues. No bruit on auscultation. So this is what we had to do. No bruit and auscultation. Systemic examination is normal. So this is the summary. So what is this? This is a summary for the case that we started off with. What do you think are the differentials, guys? Just one place I read that you should not confuse the swelling of the leg to be filariasis or something. Okay, I'm just writing one word here. I'm not sure. Okay. Just write some differentials if you want. Now, what is the diagnosis they will ask you? So you will say this is a case of varicose veins affecting the great saphenous system of vein in the right lower limbs with perforator incompetence at the saphenofemoral junction. Below knee perforator, 5 cm ankle perforator without any clinical evidence of deep vein thrombosis. What is the classification as per CEAP classification? They are giving you some huge code here. C is S4A, E is some P, A is SP. A is SP. Okay. And P is R. Did you understand anything at all? So this is the code, okay, this is the classification. You will have to arrive at the classification, okay. Basically in diagnosis, what and all you will write, it is a case of secondary varicose vein, a great saphenous or both you have to say, short saphenous, great saphenous, both are what you'll say. How is the saphenofemoral incompetence? It's incompetent. Perforators, we told you which and all are incompetent. What is the class? We'll come to the class weight and will you say what and all complications are there? You will write that, okay. What are the complications, by the way? Hemorrhage, phlebitis, ulceration, pigmentation, eczema, lipodermosclerosis, calcification of the vein, periostitis, equinous deformity. So what and all are there in that person, you'll have to tell. Okay. So basically, hemorrhage, how will you stop in a person of varicose veins? You will have to do compression and also elevate the leg. Because if you elevate the leg, that's more than enough, right? All the blood will go back. And why will it bleed, right? It won't bleed if you elevate the leg. That's a Viva question, guys. They will ask you, how will you stop hemorrhage in a person of varicose veins if he is bleeding because of the varicose veins, right? Phlebitis, then ulceration, pigmentation, eczema, all these are standard. You know all this, okay? These are the complications. So you'll write all this in the diagnosis, right? At the end of it. See, here they have shown secondary infection also in this person. Now let's go to the classification, guys. CEAP, classification of varicose veins, you should know. Basically, C is what? Clinical signs, in that you have 0 to 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Then EAP, E is, focus guys, E. What is E? Etiological classification, anatomic distribution, pathophysiologic dysfunction. All this you'll have to say. What is CEAP? Clinical signs, etiologic classification, anatomic, pathophysiologic, okay, pathophysio, anatomy, etiologic, clinical, so difficult, isn't it? Baby, come here. Can you say 0?
0.
No signs, okay.
No signs?
Yeah. One is telangiectasis.
Telangiectasis.
Yeah. Two is varicose veins.
Two is varicose
veins. Mm-hmm. Three is edema.
Edema.
Four is skin changes.
Skin changes.
And five is ulceration.
Ulceration.
Six is again ulceration. Okay. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Yeah. Okay. So guys, okay. Can you tell the grades, guys? Let's see if you can say. So, grade 0 is perfectly fine. He has nothing problem. No visible or palpable signs of venous disease. Now, grade 1 has started. Telangiectasia. So, telangiectasia can be there. It means a confluence of dilated intradermal venules of less than 1 millimeter in diameter. Confluence of dilated intradermal venules, less than 1 millimeter. Now, coming to reticular veins. Dilated subdermal veins, 1 to 3 millimeter in diameter. So specific. Then some flare they talked about, malleolar flare or something. Let's just talk about flare. Flare, what is this? Dilated group of reticular veins near medial malleolus. That will be ankle flare. Okay. If they are talking about ankle flare, ankle. Okay. So that is grade 1. Now let's move on to grade 2. Grade 2. Varicose veins. Okay, so first it starts off with all this kind of telangiectasis, reticular veins and malleolar flare. Then only it goes to varicose veins. Okay, so 2. When they say varicose veins, it's actually this stage, is it? 2. Then edema is there here in grade 3 without skin changes. Now skin changes have started. Once skin changes started, it will become more than 3. Okay, that is 4. 4 is what? Skin changes. Like pigmentation, eczema, lipodermosclerosis, all that will become 4. Now coming to 5, ulceration are 5 and 6. So a healed ulceration is 5 and an active ulceration becomes 6. Did you understand, guys? Is it too much? Guys, now let us move on to the investigations. Investigations, you have Doppler venous, okay, venous Doppler. And then you have something called as duplex ultrasound imaging. Here you have two things, that is high resolution B-mode ultrasound imaging and the Doppler ultrasound. Okay, there are two things. Look at this. This is the duplex scan showing venous reflux. So this is the duplex one. Okay, then coming to Mickey Mouse sign. Mickey Mouse sign is seen in duplex ultrasound. What is Mickey Mouse sign? The three prominent structures. Common femoral artery, great saphenous vein, and the one which is below is a vein again. That is femoral vein. Okay, common femoral vein. This is looking like the Mickey Mouse face, isn't it? Where exactly do you see Mickey Mouse sign? In the duplex ultrasound imaging, when you do for varicose veins, what will you see? You will see that there is femoral artery, long saphenous vein, and below that you have the femoral vein. The face actually is femoral vein. The face is the femoral vein. This is the long saphenous vein and this is going to be your femoral artery. Okay. There's one more sign they're talking about in this. That one is, say Mickey Mouse sign we told you. The other one is saphenous eye sign. Okay, there's some saphenous ISA, and then you have venography and something else. You can look at all these investigations. Finally, we'll go to treatment. Here you have conservative and surgery. So basically conservative, they're talking about elastic compression stockings, guys. So read more about this, okay? Then they're talking about injection line of treatment, compression sclerotherapy. This has one more term. Compression sclerotherapy. Okay, compression sclerotherapy. They'll inject something, is it? So they will inject, right? So what are they injecting here? STD actually, not sexually transmitted disease. This is some 3% sodium tetradisyl sulfate, okay, or ethanolamine they are putting, okay? So what will happen here? The vein will shrink, guys, basically that much you remember. Then tight elastic compression bandage also they will put, etc. Okay? Then these people have to do exercise also. So effective sclerosant injection into an empty vein and compression followed by exercise. Some ease are there in this, okay? All ease. Then coming to ultrasound guided foam sclerotherapy. This is also famous in some UK. Not sure if it is there here. So they're using some foam sclerosant, polydocanol. Okay? If you want, you can remember this. Then endovenous laser ablation. We'll talk about laser ablation. So here what is happening? This is a gold standard actually, if I'm not wrong. That's what they say here. Then you have the radio frequency ablation. See guys, if people have the ulcer, right? If they have venous ulcer, you have to find out why these things don't heal, okay? So you will have to check why it doesn't heal and all that. First, you'll have to fix all those issues. Okay, and then there is something called as Bisguard's method, where you will elevate the limb, then you will put crepe bandage to help the venous return. Same thing, bandage they are talking about, then you will exercise. So Bisguard regimen is for ulcer, they are talking about elevated limb. First of all, you should check why it will not heal, okay. Some underlying systemic condition, if it is there, you have to check. Then you will put elevated limb, crepe bandage, exercise. Three things are there you have to remember in this, okay. So are you okay guys? Finally, we have actually reached the surgical approach. Look at this. In this you have Trendelenburg operation. This is very important. They will ask you what and all you will ligate, etc. in this. First of all, why do you do this operation? It is if there is saphenofemoral junction incompetency, and you will do flush ligation basically of the saphenofemoral junction. The incision is an oblique incision which is made over the groin below the inguinal ligament. Below the inguinal ligament, oblique incision, remember. Starting at the level of femoral artery and extending medially for 4 cm. Okay? Then. So why will you do it? For saphenofemoral incompetence, flush ligation of the saphenofemoral junction. Okay? So if they ask you if there is saphenopopliteal junction incompetency, you will do flush ligation of the saphenopopliteal junction. Okay? Here, what and all you will ligate, right? 3 tributaries and the long saphenous vein. So 3 tributaries are these which are marked here. Superficial circumflex iliac vein, superficial epigastric vein, and superficial external pudendal vein. You should know these 3 names, okay? So the 3 tributaries ligated. Long saphenous vein is ligated close to the femoral vein, juxtafemoral flush ligation. But there is something here that they are saying in this photo at the bottom, you can see here. Long saphenous vein should never be ligated in the groin unless you demonstrate a T-junction, okay? So there are some steps for that, you'll have to look at that. Just look at this, you will do, this is a ligation with stripping operation, okay? Okay, now what you see, the next one they are talking about, subfacial ligation of Cockett and Dodd, okay? Perforators are identified deep to deep fascia and are ligated subfacially. It is indicated for perforator incompetence, obviously, perforator. Subfacial endoscopic perforator surgery. So this is SEPS, subfacial endoscopic perforator surgery. This is the one, guys, SEPS. Then what else? Recent techniques, you have something called as venous closure and Trivex. Trivex is what? Some superficial veins are sucked out, they are saying. It's a new method, Trivex. If you want, you can remember this. Okay, then. So basically they are telling that you'll do conservative approach. This is the final slide. We are showing you the summary of the treatment. Conservative, definite. For saphenofemoral incompetence, Trendelenburg operation. For perforator, you'll do subfacial, suprafacial, is it? For saphenopopliteal incompetence, same flush ligation, small varicosities, flares, etc., sclerotherapy. Small dilated veins, some hook flebectomy. Okay. Then, for deep vein thrombosis, what will you do? And the latest procedures are this laser ablation and SCPS is also latest, is it? Then what about this Trivex? Is that also latest? Yeah. So this is all about the treatment. So guys, we have looked at varicose veins completely, about the topic, the history taking, and everything we have looked at in this treatment, etc. You should know the nerves that are there in relationship to these veins, okay, because you can injure them. Like, see here, the long saphenous is with the saphenous nerve, the short saphenous is with the sural nerve, okay. So you may damage the sural nerve if you are trying to strip the SSV, short saphenous vein, okay, be careful. And similarly for this one, saphenous nerve for the long one. So what I'm understanding is these veins, right, they are talking about stripping them. So you should be very careful. They're completely removing these veins, is it? Ligating and completely removing them. So what can be the complications of these surgeries, guys? Bleeding, hematoma, pain, injury to the saphenous nerve, sural nerve, venous thrombosis, etc. Then look at this. There's something called as tumescence anesthesia, if you want to look at this, okay? It's using for radio frequency ablation and what is EVLA? Endovenous laser ablation of varicose veins. Okay, these are all our latest things. EVLA. Where shall I put it here? Okay. Guys, and just to strip these veins, there are a lot of strippers available. If you want to, you can look at these names. Remember some metal pin, something is there. Okay. So that's it, guys. In this video, we have looked at varicose veins. Bye-bye.